This is JP from the Lights Over Arkham. This time I will be trying out the brand new scenario pack, the Once and Future Kang. I will be playing it on standard difficulty with the suggested modular encounter sets. And I will be playing Hawkeye Aggression with a deck list I found on marvelcdb.com. So let's look at the Hawkeye's deck first. The deck has been made by PK, and there is a strategy guide in the deck list, so I won't go over the deck list that much. The basic idea is to shoot an arrow and use Hawkeye's basic attack, or shoot another arrow every turn. Then use the allies to control the threat, and because all of the allies are Avengers, there is Avengers Tower that helps play the allies down. Also, chase them down will help with the threat, hopefully. But that is basically enough of the deck, because I didn't build it, so I'm playing it for the first time, as I'm playing the scenario for the first time. So let's go to the scenario. The scenario has some variants to normal scenarios. So for starters, we don't add the obligation into the counter deck. It is removed from the game, so there is no Hawkeye obligation. We start from Kang the Conqueror phase 1. There are multiple phase 2 villains, so we don't know exactly which one we will get. I haven't looked at the cards that much, but I read the rules pamphlet, and we will fight Kang the Conqueror again on level 3 or phase 3. So we have 3 phases to go through. The scenario pack comes with a second version of Kang. It's the Expert Kang, so if you're playing on Expert, you will use the Expert Kang cards. There are also Anachronauts modular set, and also Master of Time modular set, which you can use in any scenario. There was also clarification that if you're playing Kang the Conqueror, you can play Kang Master of Time, because it has the different subtitle. So it's not the same Kang, or the Kang from the same time, I think. So it can be even used in this one. But I'm using the basic suggested modular sets, which are standard encounter set and temporal encounter set. Okay, that is enough of the deck I'm using and the scenario I'm playing. So let's get started. Let's start by drawing our opening hand of 6 cards with Skeleton Barton. Okay, so let's see what we got. We got the Expert Marksman, Genius, Hawkman's Quiver, Martial Prowess, Cable Arrow, and Sonic Arrow. Okay, so we definitely will keep the bow. I think we'll keep Martial Prowess, play it with Genius, and we'll also play Expert Marksman. And I think I'm discarding one of these cards, get the Hawkeye's bow, and play the Expert Marksman. Okay, well, we'll see. But I think I keep the whole hand, and we forgot to advance to Act 1B. When revealed, deal each player an encounter card, so we get one encounter card immediately. Also, Kang the Conqueror has toughness. Post interrupt, when Kang attacks, you either place one threat on the main scheme, or he gets plus 2 attack for this attack. When defeated, advance to the main scheme to stage 2 at the end of the phase. Okay. And... okay. If this stage is completed, then the players lose the game, so we can't let this main scheme advance. Even if it's the first one. We have a bunch of them more here, but okay, that's a new thing. I think there's so many cards here, I'll just put these aside. Okay. So let's start by playing I think this turn will be just set up. So we'll play the Martial Prowess. So now we can exhaust Martial Prowess to generate a strength resource for an attack event. And all, most of the arrows are attack events. I'll discard the Cable Arrow to play the Quiver. And the Sonic Arrow to play the Expert Marksman. And Exhaust Expert Marksman generate a wild resource for an arrow event. So now we have a really good way to pay for all of the arrows. I will exhaust Hawk. Oh, it's a hero action. I'm not sure if I want to go to hero yet. I think we can go to hero. Then I won't get the Hawkeye's bow, so I think I'm staying at Alter Ego for one turn. So we draw up back up to 6. So we get energy, another expert marksman, skill strike, explosive arrow, chase them down, sonic arrow. Okay, we go to the villain phase. Kang adds one threat to the main scheme. Kang schemes for 1 plus boost. You are stunned, so I'm stunned. Okay, so we add one threat here. We get an encounter card. The first encounter card is assault. It gets search. Gang up gets search. Depowered. You cannot play hero specific cards, alter ego. Discard a hero specific card from your hand, discard this obligation. Okay, so I didn't look at these cards, so these are this is an obligation. I think that is why we removed the Hawkeye's obligation. So this comes into play, and we have to get rid of that. Okay, that's interesting. And Ancient Warrior. So it has Quick Strike, it's Soldier, Temporal, 2 health, 1 scheme and 2 attack, and boost, you are stunned, but it comes into play. So that is the villain phase. Let's go to the next hero phase. Okay, let's see. I think can remove the threat by defeating the Ancient Warrior and playing Chase Dev down. But first thing first, we really need the Hawkeye's bow. So I will spend as an action one resource of any type. And we look for the Hawkeye's bow. So it was near the bottom of the deck, so good thing we can search for it. We shuffle our deck. The bow is a zero cost card we just played. Then let's flip. Before that, We can't play that actually yet. So I'll discard one. Let's discard the Sonic Arrow. So we get rid of this. Okay, now we can play the bow. I will flip. We'll use the Hawkeye's Quiver. We look at the top 5 cards, and this was FAQ'd that you shuffle the cards into the deck, so now you can't just put them back. I think we'll get the Vibranium Arrow. So we shuffle this back into the deck. I actually like this way better. It felt too powerful that you could check what cards are coming with the Hawkeye's Quiver. So we have the Vibranium Arrows underneath the... Well, I'll just keep them over the Quiver. It's easier so you can see what cards are there. Next, we will... I think we'll just get rid of the stunned. Then we will use... This is... we'll use the Expert Marksman to play Explosive Arrow from our hand. And... We have to exhaust Hawkeye's bow. So we deal 3 damage to the villain and each minion engaged with that player. I choose Hawkeye, of course. Well, so we deal 3 damage, so we remove the tough and we also defeat Ancient Warrior. Then we'll use the chase them down to remove the threat. And I think I'm keeping these cards in hand. We'll ready up. Next turn we have a double resource to play something expensive like the Vibranium Armor or something. But yeah, now let's draw back up to 5. So we get 2 electric arrows and press the advantage. So electric arrow will stun the villain and press the advantage will combo nicely with the electric arrow. We go to the villain phase, we add a threat to the main scheme. Kang attacks, I will add a threat to the main scheme. And Kang attacks for 2 plus 2, so 4. I'll take 4 damage. Then we'll get an encounter card, and it is Time Travel Tactics, Search. When revealed, each player takes 1 indirect damage for each obligation in their play area. I don't have any, so that just searches. Time Travel Hijinks, Temporal, and it's an obligation. When revealed, discard the highest cost card you control, then place it face down under this card. Discard a energy resource from your hand, discard this obligation, discard its face down card underneath this obligation. Okay, so the highest cost card I have is Martial Prowess, so it goes underneath this. That really sucks, but what can you do? And that is the villain phase, so let's go to the hero phase. I think this turn we'll try to shoot 2 arrows at least. So I think we'll start by shooting an electric... No, first thing I'll do is get 1 card on the quiver again. We'll get the... Do we want the cable or vibranium arrow? I think we'll need the cable arrow to get rid of the threat. So I think first, let's see if we have a we're not playing two electric arrows, so I'll discard this to get rid of the application. Oh, it's an alter ego action, so you'll have to flip. I'll save that for alter ego. Okay. So I think this turn we'll shoot just the electric arrow, use the energy, and we have the exhaust focus bow. We'll deal 3 damage. We'll stun the villain. Then I'll ready Hawkeye's bow. So action exhaust Hawkeye, ready Hawkeye's bow. I will use the expert marksman to play cable arrow. So I'll remove a 3 threat from a scheme. Then I will use skill strike to press the advantage. So deal 2 damage to an enemy. If the enemy is stunned or confused, draw 1 card. So we deal 2 damage and we draw a card. Get She-Hulk. Yeah, that is exhausted again. I think we'll flip. We'll spend the energy resource to get rid of this, and this gets discarded. It looks like there's you shouldn't have many applications to play, but that is our turn. We're ready up. We draw back up to 6. So we have a chase them down. Avenger Tower, Mockingbird, 2 press the advantages, and She-Hulk. Okay, so let's go to the villain phase. We add a threat to the main scheme. Kang schemes for 1+3. So we are at 5. That is not good. And encounter card is Rampage. When defeated, discard cards from the top of the encounter deck. Until a minion is discarded, put that minion into play. Engage with the player who defeated this scheme. Has 4 threat on it. And it adds an acceleration token. So I think we need to get rid of that. But that is the villain phase. Let's go to the next hero phase. So we really need to get rid of that threat as soon as possible. I think we'll play Mockingbird. And let's see. I think She-Hulk is too expensive at the moment, so we could play She-Hulk. I think we could use She-Hulk and chase them down to play Avengers Tower, then play both of the press the advantages to get Mockingbird into play. I think the first thing I will do is heal. I'll heal 3. We'll flip. We'll flip. Yeah, I'll play the Avengers Tower. I'll use the Avengers Tower and the both of the press the advantages to play Mockingbird, and Mockingbird will ward for 2 here. I will use the quiver to look for an arrow. The vibranium arrow is the only arrow we found. Quickly shuffle the deck. And if that is the turn, we'll ready up. Fortunately, we couldn't take advantage of the stunt, but what can you do? We'll draw back up 5. We get the explosive arrow, queen carrier, Earth's mightiest heroes, skilled strike, and Hulk. Okay, so good thing we got Hulk, because now we can get an ally to block attacks from next round on. We'll go to the villain phase, we'll add 2 threat here. Kang tries to attack, but it's stunned. We remove the stun and then counter card is time travel hijinks. Discard the highest cost card you control, then place it face down under it here. So the highest cost is Mockingbird, unfortunately. And that is the villain phase, so let's go to the next hero phase. Well, this is... those threats are quite a problem at the moment. Let's use the quiver to look for a card. Hopefully we can find something useful. Well, we didn't find any arrows, which is a big problem. I think we'll have to. I think we'll have to try to advance Kang so we can get rid of that act, so we don't lose. That is, I think, that's the play here. So we'll use the Queen Carrier and Avengers Tower to play Hulk. We will see here. We'll play Skill Strike to boost Hawkeye's attack by 2, so it's 5. So it's 2 plus 2 plus 1, it's 5, so we hit for 5. And then I'll use Earth's Mightiest Heroes, exhaust an Avenger character you control, ready another Avenger character you control. And I will hit again for 3 damage. So, when defeated, advance the main scheme to stage 2 at the end of the phase. So at the end of the phase, I think, yeah, it's at the end of the hero phase. So at the end of the hero phase, we'll advance, and I think that's it. But let's see. Yeah, we played that. We have the explosive arrow in hand, and nothing to do with that. Actually, let's back up a bit. I won't hit with Hawkeye. So we are at 2 on Kang. I will rather play the explosive arrow, dealing 3 damage, and will advance to phase 2 with that. Then will flip. We will spend this to get rid of this. And I think that's our turn. So we end our hero phase. So now we advance to the Master of Time. Kang reels back, but he saves himself by separating the heroes through time and space. When revealed, place one acceleration token here for each side skill in play. Each player reveals a random stage 3A in turn order. Remove any unused stage 3 schemes from the game. So we have four stage 3s. Let's shuffle them up. So I will, because I can see the text, I will shuffle them a bit. Don't look at them and pick the one that is at the bottom. So let's see what we get. And I don't have any preference here because I haven't played this scenario before. Okay, so we'll get the Chronopolis. When revealed, create your own game area and place this scheme in it. Add Kang Immortus. So we get Kang Immortus to the game area and deal yourself an infinite counter card. So I think this Kang is defeated. I think so. So just put it here. We'll get this. I think this is removed. This is a bit unclear. I'll check the... Okay, I'll check the rules and I'll be right back. Okay, so how this works is that I forgot to flip this 2A to 2B. So it stays in play. I think threat stays there, but there is no threat out threshold on that 2B act card. Instead we get the 3B here. And I'll just put it here because this is basically our game area. We don't have a Kang in the main play area, which is like off limits because we're in another time period. We have to deal with this Kang, and it has 18 health. Just add that. And it has tough. And this villain cannot take damage while a minion is in play. When defeated, remove the Chronopolis from the game at the end of that phase. Join another game area. So when all players, so when Hawkeye enters back to this play area, we advance to 4A. I'm just wondering, do we add threat there or not? That is a bit unclear, but I play it that we won't, because if this takes many turns, that is just really, really straight. Yeah, we won't add threat here because there are no indicators how much threat you would add, and there is no villain to scheme. Okay, yeah, that seems like logical. We'll draw back up to 6. Now we get the combat training sentry. Chase them down, Spider Girl, Earth's Mightiest Heroes, and Endurance. And yeah, we forgot to add an encounter card. So, Kang Immortus schemes for. Oh, let's start here. So we add one threat here. Plus one acceleration token. So this is here, and this is on this one. At least that's how I'm thinking it works. If you played this more than me and know how this works, you can leave a comment in the video comments. So I'll check those out and maybe play a bit better next time. But this is a blind playthrough, so I'm bound to make some mistakes, probably. The scheming is 2 plus 2, so 6 total now. I really need to get rid of that threat. And encounter cards, first one is depowered, so you cannot play hero-specific cards. And stolen memories, obligation, when revealed, place the top 8 cards of your deck face down under this card. Alter ego action, discard a mental resource from your hand, discard this obligation, discard each face down card under this obligation. So luckily we only have 4. But yeah, I think we get an extra encounter card for next turn. Shuffle up our deck. So far I'm quite liking this scenario. It's really different from the previous scenarios we've had, including the new scenarios in the Rise of Red Skull box. So I'm really happy this came out this early. We have a lot more villains to play against now. Okay, I think, yeah, that was the second. So I think that is the villain phase. We'll go to the next hero phase. Okay, so I think we need to try and hit Kang down as fast as possible. But first, let's see, I think we'll use chase them down to get rid of this. We'll discard this, we discarded strength, earth, mightiest heroes, war machine and skill strike, so no arrows there. We can't play hero specific cards, we don't have any, but we don't have any in hand, so I can't get rid of that. That sucks. So we have to I think we'll just flip. I'll use Avengers Tower and Endurance. Combat training and Earth's Mightiest Heroes. Now I'll use the Spider Girl, so I'll keep that in hand. Play Sentry, we'll get an encounter card. Sentry will ward for 2. I will use Earth Mightiest Heroes to exhaust Hulk to ready Sentry. Sentry will ward for 2. And I will hit with Hawkeye to get rid of this stuff. And that is our turn, so we draw back up to 5. Be ready up. Oh yeah, before I draw back up to 5, I'll use the Quiver to search for one arrow. We get the Sonic Arrow, and we Shuffle the deck. And we could have actually played the Sonic Arrow. Oh no, it's cost 2. Okay, so it's there for next turn. And we get energy, electric arrow, skilled strike, rest advantage, and genius. So nice to see 2 double resources, so we can shoot 2 big arrows. Okay, the villain phase starts. We add 2 threat here. And Kang attacks, Hulk will defend. 2 plus 0, Hulk takes 2 damage. Encounter card, so the first one is temporal shield attached to Kang. Forced interrupt when Kang is attacked. Discard temporal shield, prevent all damage from this attack and deal 1 damage to the attacker. And future weapons attached to Kang. Forced interrupt when Kang attacks, the attack gains overkill. If this attack damages a hero, that hero is stunned. After this attack, discard future weapons. And the last one is time travel tactics. Search each player takes 1 direct indirect damage for each obligation. We have 1 obligation, and this gains search, and we'll take 1 damage. The search card is macro bots. Guard retaliate 1. Okay, and 4 health. So we need to defeat that first before we can deal damage to Kang, which will be a bit tough, but let's see how the next turn goes. So let's go to the next turn. We can't play any of the arrows, which is a shame because of this stupid card. Yeah, just noticed that this yet the Hulk defended, so it's exhausted. So so I think we will play skill strike to boost Hawkeye to 5 damage and hit the macro bots. Retaliate for 1. No, it doesn't because it dies. Fortunately, we don't have a chase them down, so I think sentry will just thwart for 2. We have to flip. And we have to get rid of the electric arrow to get rid of this one, unfortunately. Before I went to Alter Ego, I used the Quiver in hero mode. So I get the protect the explosive arrow. Yeah, that's more variety to the arrows, so. And yeah, before we flipped, I think I would have played the let's back up a bit. So this in theory is in play yet still. So we'll play the press the advantage to deal 2 damage here. Actually it doesn't deal any damage. It just removes the temporal shield and we'll take 1 damage. Now we'll flip and we'll discard that to discard that. Yeah. Making a bit some mistakes, but it is what it is with the new cards. We'll ready up. We'll draw back up to 6. Okay, so hopefully we get a minion so we can get rid of some threat next turn. We'll add 2 threat the scheme. Gang schemes for 2+ nothing. You are stunned. Well, that's a shame. So, 2 threat here. And encounter card is Chitauri soldier. Okay, well, we got one minion, so we can trigger chase them down. That is really good. Okay, so that is the villain phase. Let's go to the next hero phase. I can't heal because I need to be ready to get rid of that stunned. So I think I'll play Queen Carrier down. I'll use the energy and skill strike. Then I will flip. I'll attack, I'll remove the stun. I'll use Expert Marksman to use Explosive Arrow. So we'll deal 3 damage, but Kang can't take damage, so only the soldier takes damage. I will trigger both, chase them down. Actually, I'll just trigger one of them. So we'll remove 2 threat from here. Then I'll use the Avengers Tower and King Carrier. Oh yeah, and I only played this when I had flip, because you have to have the Avengers trait, which is just stupid. Okay, so I'll play the Mockingbird, and Sentry will thwart for 2. Mockingbird will thwart for 2. And yeah, I have to pay for that. We'll search for an arrow. We'll get the cable arrow. Be ready up. We draw back up to 5. We get a sonic arrow, explosive arrow, electric arrow, expert marksman, and Earth's mightiest heroes. Kang will attack, Hulk will defend. We have, first we add 2 threat here. 2 plus 4, 2 is 4, so Hulk is defeated. And this attack gains overkill, so let's back up a bit. So when the villain initiates an attack against you, spend 1 resource of any type and return Mockingbird to your hand. Prevent all damage from this attack. Okay, so I'll exhaust this to generate a resource. I'll return Mockingbird to my hand, and that attack is the damage from that attack is cancelled, and we discard this. And encounter card is manipulated time stream treachery. When revealed, discard each event from your hand. If no events are discarded this way, this card gets searched. So this is painful. We lose all of these events. Well, that was not nice. Okay, so that is the villain phase. Let's go to the next hero phase. Well, Kang really screwed us with that manipulated time stream, but let's see. I think I'll. Well, I have to keep the Mockingbird, that's just so good. I'll have to hit with Sentry, so I'll hit for 3. I will shoot a Vibranium arrow. So we'll deal 6. I'll use the Expert Marksman and another Expert Marksman from my hand to deal 6 damage. And I will attack for another 3 damage. That is our turn. Let's use the quiver again. So we get the cable arrow. Double this up. Go back up to 5. And we get an extra counter card. So we have Press the Advantage, x2, She-Hulk, Martial Prowess, and Mockingbird. And Kang attacks, Hulk will defend, Kang hits for... Yeah, before that we'll add 2 threat here. So 2 plus 1 is 3, so that's enough to defeat Hulk. Then counter cards are advance. Schemes for 2 plus 3, so 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. That is unfortunately too much. Force. The response after this stage is completed, place 1 set aside Kang's Dominion phase of under stage 4A. At the end of the phase, remove Kang, Immortus and this stage from the game and combine your game area with another game area. So we get Kang's Dominion. Okay, let's see how this works. After this stage is completed, place 1 set aside Kang's Dominion. Okay. Face down under stage 4A. At the end of the phase, remove Kang Mortus and this stage from the game and combine your game area with another game area. So we combine it to that game area. Okay, just put this underneath here. So, the other counter card is that goes to Kang. Then we remove this Kang and this Kang from the game. So, but I think this gets removed too. Let's see. So, when players can join this game area unless there are no other game areas remaining. When all the players have joined this game area, advance to stage 4A. Kang's Wrath. You used your enemy technologies to reunite in the present day, just in time to counter Kang's assault on Earth. When revealed, reveal Kang 3. Where is Kang 3? Here it is. So Kang 3 is a 2 scheme, 2 attack toughness, forced interrupt. When Kang attacks, you either place 1 threat on the main scheme or he gets plus 2 attack for this attack. When defeated, the players win the game. Okay, so we need to just defeat that version, and it has 20 hit points per player. So we really need to just try to burn it down fast, hopefully. Okay. Reveal each face down Kang's dominion under this stage. So this gets revealed. And this turns. When revealed, each player searches the encounter deck discard pile and set aside area for their nemesis minion and puts it in play. Engage with them. Shuffle this the encounter deck. So set aside area. So yeah, we get our nemesis minion. It says quick strike. So it deals 2 damage. So that sucks. Okay, and so I think that is the villain phase. Let's not really forget to add these here. We are ready to go to the next hero phase. Okay, Kang has tough, but luckily we have one vibranium arrow here. I think we'll use the cleaver first. Let's look for a arrow card. No arrow cards here. How much can we deal damage this turn? Let's see. We can shoot 2 arrows, but first we need to see if we can stun somehow. Can confuse an enemy. Help. And remove 3 threat. Well, I think I'm playing the Mockingbird down. So I still need 1. I'll use. Think about this for a moment. Okay, so we can't deal damage before this is removed, so we need to remove threat somehow. I think the easiest way to remove that is by using one of the cable arrows. We'll do that. So we remove 3 threat. This gets removed and we'll deal 1 encounter card. And then we'll use the Queen Carrier to press the advantage and deal 2 damage Crossfire. And we'll defeat Crossfire. Then I think I will use the Avengers Mansion and press the advantage and Martial Prowess to play Mockingbird. Mockingbird will dwarf for 2. And that is our turn. So we ready up. I may have had Hawkeye exhausted for no reason, but it is what it is. Can't remember now, so we drop. Back up. Yeah, I'll just draw. So we have Earth's Mightiest Heroes, Strength, Skill Strike, Energy, and She-Hulk. So Kang attacks. We'll add threat first. So we get 2. Kang attacks. Thank you. So I think the attack happens. If I use the Mockingbird to just cancel the attack. So this still gets. And give Kang a tough status card. Well, he already has it. And encounter cards. First one is weakened, obligation, force response. After you use a basic hero power, take one damage. Alter ego, discard strength resource from your hand, discard this obligation. Energy blast, treachery. Kang attacks you. I have to defend 2 plus 2, so I'm at 1. Okay, well, that sucked. I think I have to go to the alter ego to heal next turn. But yeah, that's the villain phase. Let's go to the next hero phase. Okay, so first things first, we'll use strength. We'll use the energy and strength, or skill strike and energy, and an Avengers Tower to play She-Hulk. She-Hulk will taunt for 2. See, I'll play the vibranium arrow, so it gains piercing. So we discard the tough, then we deal 6. And I think we'll use the expert. Oh yeah, we can't use the bow, but I'll search for a arrow. We get explosive arrow. We'll flip. I'll use the Queen Carrier to get rid of this one. I think that is our turn. Are we ready up? We get Spider Girl to chase them down. Expert Marksman, we have the Mockingbird and Earth Mightiest Heroes in hand. Yeah, and She-Hulk has 2 damage on her. We add the threats here. And Kang schemes for 2 plus 2. So we are at 9. Encounter card is frozen in time, attached to your identity. Forced interrupt when attached. Character would ready, discard this card instead. Okay. Let's put it here. And that is the villain phase. Let's go to the next hero phase. Okay. Let's see what we can do. So, we can hit with She-Hulk, it's 3 damage. Then we can use Earth's Mightiest Heroes and hit again. We just play Spider-Girl first. So we will hit for, then it's 7. Then we have some arrows, so I think we're pretty close. But first thing, I have to heal, so I don't die to a random damage. Next time I would ready. I remove that, so that doesn't work, so we'll flip. I'll use Avengers Tower to play Spider-Girl, and we'll use Mockingbird. Oh, let's use the Smiteous. The expert marksman for that. No, let's use the chase them down. Then I'll use Queen Carrier, expert marksman, and chase them down to play Mockingbird. We'll shoot one arrow, I'll use the expert marksman, and we'll first we'll search for an arrow. We don't find any. So now we shoot an arrow. We'll shoot cable arrow. So we remove three red from here. And She-Hulk will hit for 3 damage. We'll exhaust Spider Girl. Ready She-Hulk. She-Hulk will hit for 1, 2, 3, 4 damage. And Mockingbird will. Let's think about it. We are at 6, so if we get an advance, we might lose. So I think we have to try and play it safe. So we'll remove. Good threat from there. And we remove this when Hawkeye tries to ready. We draw back up to 5. We get Smiteous Hero, Vibranium Armor, Rest Advantage, Explosive Arrow, and Genius. So next turn we'll just use an arrow and an attack to defeat Kang, hopefully. But let's go to the villain phase. We add 2 threat here. And Kang attacks. I will defend with Spider Girl. No. I'll just cancel the attack with Mockingbird. So Kang will use the Queen Carrier for that. Okay. So we get this back into hand. And counter card is Assault. Let's defend with Spider Girl. Can get stuff. Spider Girl is defeated. Okay. That is the villain phase. Let's go to the next hero phase. Okay. I think we're gonna win on this turn. So I'll use Genius and Avengers Tower to play Mockingbird. I will use Expert Marksman and Earth's Mightiest Hero, no, Explosive Arrow to play Vibranium Arrow, so it has piercing, so we remove the tough, deal 6 damage, and we'll just press the advantage, we deal 2, and that is the game. So that was Kang. The Once and Future Kang, and with Hawkeye aggression. So first off, I really liked how this aggression deck works and how the Kang scenario works also. It's really interesting, a bit difficult to grasp at first play, but with multiple plays I think the mechanics of the scenario start to unravel and it gets a bit easier to manage, and I really think this scenario is at its best with the multiple players, not as a solo scenario. But hope you guys like this playthrough, and of course, if I misplayed something, let me know in the comments so I can play better next time. Thanks for watching, and until next time.